ma'am. Can you squeeze my fingers?
Boom, doors open. In come the paramedics with this lady.
Can you open your eyes? Let's get her into this bed.
She is semi-conscious.
Ma'am, can you open your eyes?
She's responsive. She's what we call a triage category one.
Nonverbal, pale. Let's get her changed into a gown. I need an IV, monitors, pulse ox. Be right back in.
She's in shock. She needs immediate intervention.
Sir, can we have a word outside? Can you tell me exactly what happened?
Doctor, I don't know. She was fine 1 minute, and the next she was just on the floor.
Did she consume anything out of the ordinary?
Not that I know of. You know, my papa dying has been really stressful on everyone, too.
This had occurred after the death of a family member. So, of course, one of the things that I consider is this could be a psychological reaction to stress.
My head. My head.
She's complaining about her head. That could be a sign of a bleed. What's your blood pressure?
72 over 48.
Low blood pressure is dangerous because blood pressure is what delivers blood, and therefore oxygen, to all of the vital organs.
That's pretty low. We can probably rule out a bleeding stroke.
When your blood pressure gets too low, you don't deliver enough oxygen, and you can have a heart attack or problems with your brain, such as this lady was having.
Did she fall or hit her head?
Well, not that I know of. Could this be a reaction to anything that she was exposed to?
Certainly.
We hear these voices outside the curtain, and I see the husband stiffen up and apologize for what's about to happen. And in come the husband's parents.
What happened to my daughter-in-law?
My parents.
Is she gonna be okay?
And right away, I feel like they're taking over the room.
We don't know yet.
My father's laying in wake. This can't be happening. Not today!
As much as I was hearing them ask questions about the patient, I was hearing them complaining about how this impacted them.
And let's give her a liter bolus. Let's get that started.
Okay.
A bolus is a volume of normal saline.
Your wife's blood pressure is dangerously low.
We give this as an initial therapy to try to bring the blood pressure back up.
And that's gonna be a lot easier when I know what it is that she's taken.
I stress to the husband the importance that we know what it was that she might have been exposed to, because that could significantly impact how we treat her.
Well, we kind of,
Just as the husband's about to tell me,
God!
More people are coming in, and they're loud.
I didn't know how long you were going to be here, so I brought you a little snack.
They're bringing in food.
But Pooley wouldn't want us to waste this food.
Oh, it was terrible.
Where's the pita, Jeannie?
I want to focus on this patient.
Oh, Ricky's gonna pick it up.
I was like, please, give me some space.
And the others are coming.
Others?
If more family members arrive, I'm worried that I'll never be able to get an answer from the husband about what really happened to his wife.
This is about to go from bad to worse.
All of a sudden, she's able to speak a little bit more clearly.
George, you're so bad.
I'm thinking, could be a sex-related issue. The husband may be involved.
So George, I need to know what she may have been exposed to.
Nitro something.
Was it a nitroglycerin tablet?
No, it was like a tube, like toothpaste.
That sounds like nitro paste. Nitro paste is applied to the chest wall, and that can certainly increase blood flow, but it will also lower the blood pressure. Does your wife have a heart condition?
No.
And where on earth would you get your hands on this nitro toothpaste stuff?
Papu's medicine cabinet.
These symptoms and signs could be consistent with exposure to nitro paste.
George, I need to know where you applied the nitro paste. We need to remove any of the excess nitro paste to stop any further absorption.
We need to decontaminate her. We need to get it off of her.
So I need to know now, where did you apply the nitro paste?
I'm not sure applied is the right word.
George.
Shush, Samantha's trying to say something.
It's so itchy down there.
There's something that he doesn't want to say with his parents in the room.
Can you please escort the family out of the room?
All right, everyone, come on, let's go.
Sometimes it gets to the point where I just have to say, family, go. And if I have a family that's threatening the patient or threatening the nurses, that's an easy decision, the family has to leave. But a lot of times, I want to make sure that the family is part of the patient's treatment and recovery. And being able to include them in that without letting them get in the way, well, sometimes it makes me pull my hair out.
Come on.
What about Papuli? What's the rush? He's not going anywhere.
The family was clearly not very understanding of why I wanted them to leave the room. No, I'm fine. Thank you very much. The family leaves, and I'm finally alone with just my patient and the husband. And I'm hoping now I'll finally get the answers that I need. And why on earth is there nitro paste on her vagina? George, I need you to level with me. I need you to tell me exactly how she had contact with this heart medication. It could be very serious if it wasn't prescribed for her.
Okay, okay. Somehow, I guess, some of it got on her vagina when we were having sex. I put it on myself and it got in her.
Finally, I understood how it got there, but I still didn't know why.
And there's something else. My flag is still flying at full mast.
You still have an erection? Oh, I get it. You use this as a vasodilator, like the little blue pill, to cause the erection so that you could have intercourse with your wife. This is Dr. Yeo, our urologist. Dr. Yeo, have you ever heard of anyone using nitro paste on a penis as a sex aid?
No, I haven't. Let's take a look. Whoa! That's not what it should be used for.
But is it normal to still have an erection?
You still have an erection?
I've never seen a man more embarrassed than this poor guy was.
Ooh, eat.
The wife is improving with our resuscitation.
Hey, Gus, you going camping later with that tin? Oh.
Now I understand how it happened, but I'm still confused about why it happened.
So am I. George, you're lucky you don't have any damage from this situation.
Oh, well, all right. I'll tell you why it happened. Because George and I are running out of time. Psst, George.
At the wake, she gets his attention.
Seriously, what are you doing?
I'm ovulating.
Now at Papu's? I mean, he's still downstairs.
Look, this is the last day of my cycle, okay? If we're really serious about getting pregnant, it has to be now or we'll have to wait another month. Okay. What's the matter?
I feel under pressure right now.
Okay, relax. Maybe modern medicine can help. There's gotta be something in here that will work. Little blue pills, maybe? Hey, what's this? Nitro paste.
That's my Papu's heart condition medicine. I mean, he would smear it on his chest and it would open up blood vessels.
Gets the blood flowing, right? Let's try it. Wow.
Whoa.
That worked better than I expected. Whoa.
Sam? Oh my God, Sam, what's the matter? Oh no. Help?
And that's the last thing I remember. Oh my God. I can't believe what I'm hearing. This is what happened up in that bathroom? While Papu was lying in state.
I can't imagine anything more humiliating than what this poor man was going through.
Dude, you had sex in Papu's house and used his medicine at his wake? That's crazy!
Now be nice to the kid.
I just wanted to say, family, would you please cut this guy some slack?
Papu wasn't shy himself. He liked the little freaky stuff now and then.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh. Why did I faint and not George?
Nitro paste is designed to be absorbed through the skin. When you put it inside and it's on a mucous membrane, it's going to be absorbed 10 times faster, and the effects will be 10 times stronger.